Jay Moore. You guys think Jay Moore's gonna get his?
Minding my own business, and you being the moron that you are doing dog sounds to the crowd. Hey, get on him, Rich. Why don't you get these losers back to where they belong, all right?
I'm done, big man.
There's nothing you can do.
I'm done, big man.
There's nothing that this promotion can do. Come on. You guys are losers, and at the snap of my finger, you can lose those titles right here, right now.
No, you can't. There's no
titles. Back off, boys. Back off. It's not about the wrestling business anymore. It's about Jay Moore and the Infamous Five from here on out.
What's he doing out here? He already worked. He already wrestled tonight.
Wait,
ridiculous. What's he doing here? Like, chasing away the infamous line. Like, what is this?
Oh, he's got something to say. He wants a microphone.
Jay Moore, you like to play number games? Hey, last show, wasn't it you and him? And there was five of them really against you?
I'm against one. For a team.
Hey, you remember the odds when we hung out with this guy? Remember how tight we were with that? Do you remember that? Do you remember that, Jay Moore? Do you know whose fault that was?
They were all the infamous five. The original infamous five.
Do you guys know whose fault that was?
Oh! Oh! Nice clothesline. Out of nowhere. This is a new side of Marcus Ryan. I'm liking it.
I thought Custom was coming out here to support Mark House. They have his back.
Well, I guess not.
Is this a match?
Well, you know how they say the house always wins, but I don't think tonight the house is going to win.
Well, I don't know what Marcus Ryan's doing. If he's aligned himself once again with the infamous five, infamous six, seven of them now, I don't even know.
This is great. This is great. I'm loving this side of Custom. Hard job. Excellent.
Wow. Yeah, I mean, this is a different Custom than we saw earlier tonight.
I'm liking it.
Perhaps that steal of the wind was the final straw for Custom.
Oh, I don't blame him. Like, you get in Crossfire, you get bad officiating. Like, the bookers, the management, they're just, their heads are so far up their butts that they keep mismanaging the Infamous Five. They're always trying to screw them over. It's good to see Marcus Ryan stick up for the Infamous Five.
Yeah, but Marcus Ryan and Mark House share the fact that they both got basically booted from the Infamous Five at the behest of Jay Moore.
Well, the thing that started the demise of the original Infamous Five was House losing that title. When he lost that belt, that's when the foundation started to crack. I blame everything on Mark House right now. He had this coming to him.
Well, he's definitely suffering the consequences. Mark House is ready to take on Rob Rage, but Marcus Ryan out here.
This is great. Like I said earlier, Rob Rage has no business fighting. He is hired as Jay Moore's bodyguard. That means he's not a wrestler. What the? Old school. Okay, that's ridiculous. He should not be putting his hands on a wrestler.
Well, that's what he gets, right? Eddington James is a no-nonsense ref.
Careful, Custom. He might have a heart attack. There we go.
Marcus, oh, no. Up and over. Oh, right to the floor.
That was a hard landing. That was a hard landing.
Right in the lap of the infamous ones, and they're not touching him. Rage is out there, though. Oh, Rage getting a shot to the mouth for his troubles. And now Mark House with the top rope.
Oh, my God. Yes. What a move by Mark House.
He just took out half of the infamous group.
Well, that's what Crossfire Wrestling's all about. What is he doing? He's going after the Infamous Five. This is ridiculous. They didn't touch him. They didn't interfere in the match.
Well, I think we know whose house it is now. It's Mark's house.
I say we burn down this house, Custom. Come on.
Custom made man. He's always been a dirty vet.
Mark House is just on fire right now.
Infamous Sable's been sent packing. We just got Jay Moore and Rage still here at ringside. Last Custom hits a nice fisherman suplex.
Nice move, Custom. Excellent job there, buddy. He's giving him the thumbs up to Jay Moore. I love it. But Mark House is no slouch. You got to be right on top of him. Can't give him time to recuperate. See, this isn't fair. Right now, the ref, old school, he has a grudge with Custom. He shouldn't even be out here wrestling. This is a conflict of... He shouldn't be out here reffing.
Because he shoved him? Custom threatened his official responsibilities. I mean...
Oh, well, this guy's overworked. We need another guy out here. I don't trust him. Conflict of interest.
If you have such a problem with it, why don't you put on some stripes? Wow, what a spine buster.
Because I'm here and this is where I need it. That was beautiful.
Oh, my.
That was beautiful.
Jay Moore gives you shout-outs? Good grief.
Of course. Of course. Infamous Notes Classic. That was a beautiful spine buster there. You don't see too many good spine busters like that. except for guys like Arn Anderson and Bobby Roode.
Marcus Ryan, you got years of experience in the ring. But I agree with this crowd. He sold out to the Infamous Five. Give me a break.
He didn't sell out nothing. I see it as a wise business investment. It's a wise move. Oh, come on. Oh, good rollout by Custom. Oh!
Look at that. Wrestling prowess here. Oh, wow, DDT. Marcus Ryan landed right on his head. Wow. He's not moving. But Mark House is feeding off the energy here. Going for a cover. Oh, yes. So close. Oh,
thank God he got that shoulder up. Good job, Custom. Come on, Custom. Nice jawbreaker.
Oh, what a leg sweep. We see a backslide here. No, a back suplex neckbreaker.
Wow. Come on. Come on, Custom.
Oh, but Jay Moore is getting up on the apron now.
See, Marcos isn't the smartest man in the world by getting distracted by Jay Moore right here. And what? I don't know why he's put his hands on Jay Moore. Jay Moore is a manager. He's not a wrestler.
Yeah, but Marcos has been waiting to get his hands on Jay Moore for a while now. Oh, yeah, throws him off right into the grip of Rage, who nails him in that forearm.
That's
referee didn't see it. Marcus with a Death Valley driver. The same move he almost won the opening match with.
That was a
vicious Death Valley
driver. There we go.
Good enough to get the win.
There we go.
Huge win.
And he just beat the former number one contender. What does that say for Custom Marcus Ryan in the world title picture?
Well, he quite possibly moves up in the ranks. Of course, he'll have to wait until next year to be involved in the title picture.
Nice. Choking with his shirt. This is beautiful.
Yeah, I think if we questioned Marcus Custom Ryan's allegiance to the Infamous family before, there's no question about it now. He's working with the Infamous family.
I love it. A post-match beatdown at its finest. Yeah, ring the bell as if that ever stopped anybody.
We need security over here. This is an assault, a gang beating.
No one can stop the Infamous Five. This is beautiful. Yes. Well, that's not a statement. I don't know what is.
Well, one more spot for the Infamous family. Whoa. Goes to Marcus Ryan.
It's a handshake here.
There it is.
Could this mean Custom is a part of the Infamous Five?
Sure it is. What else could it mean?
Could it be a one-night thing?
They're standing there. No, Chris. They're standing there arm in arm, sharing a ring together, beating down Marcus.
Oh, who doesn't want to beat down Marcus? It was great.
I'm sure they'll work out the contracts after the show and Marcus Ryan will be the newest member of the Infamous stable.
This is great. Crossfire. I've never seen anything like this. The Infamous Five is just running all over it.
Not five of them, Chris. There's more now.
It doesn't matter. The numbers game, it doesn't matter. Infamous Five will run Crossfire by the end of December. This is great.
Why, Custom? Why'd you do it?
Oh, this is something the fans wanted to see. Marcus Custom Ryan, he's back at home. One of the original members of the Infamous Five. This is great. It's so funny how the fans just turn their backs on you. They like you 15 minutes ago, but you start hanging out with new people, they turn on you. These fans suck. Now this is a contest that the fans are going to enjoy. You got two great tag teams going after each other.
Yeah, the fans, myself included, this is going to be a great tag team contest. And I hope that Chris LaFont and Sexy Monkey are watching from the back, because they're going to have to face the winners next year.
As they should be watching. You don't become champion not paying attention to your competition. If so, you don't stay fresh. You don't stay on top of the mountain. You got to know who you're dealing with. That's exactly how it is.
Right now, it's we called them Sexy Time in the first half. They want to be known as Monkey Business. That's the Sexy Monkey and Chris LaPlante, your new tag team champions here at Jingle Bell Brawl 3. And what a show it's been, Chris.
It's been a great show. But after this match, I'm going to say that Monkey Business, their days are numbered with the winners of this match.
I'm not starting this match until they shut up.
Call him, Primo. These fans are garbage.
Yeah, having a bit of a hard time here with the St. Catharines crowd.
They won't start until you're quiet. It's up.
As they should. Well, yeah. They're one of the most decorated tag teams in the Niagara region.
But they're much more popular in Niagara Falls than they are here in St. Catharines.
Oh, well, 5-minute drive. It's not that far.
What road do you take? It's at least 10.
Oh, well. Like, that's what bugs me about the fans. Yeah, we like you 1 minute, we don't like you the next. Friggin' make up your mind. Get your stuff in gear. And support who you like. Like, I'm going to be supporting the Italianos in this match because I like them.
Oh, yeah, don't kid yourself. I'm sure a lot of fans made that 10-plus minute drive from Niagara Falls to cheer on the Italianos.
But still, they're local boys. They're local boys. Flatliners aren't. They're not that local.
No, but they are very popular. They've done nothing but impress crowds no matter where they go.
Oh, well, doesn't matter to me. These fans, they just don't have their heads in anything. They don't understand things. Kids are too busy with their internet, with their video games. They don't really pay attention to wrestling. Like, they're sheep. They follow like the guy. Like, oh, this guy's cheering for him. I'm just gonna cheer for him too. No. Make up a choice on your own. That's why I'm with the Italianos. Because I'm a sophisticated man, I'm intelligent, I know tag team wrestling.
Quite the long-winded response there, the tangent that you went on, Chris, but I think I get your point here. You like the Italianos no matter what the fans think? Did I follow you correctly there?
Exactly, I don't care what anyone thinks, the only opinion that matters is classic Chris's.
Well, how about this? I like the Flatliners. No matter what the crowd thinks. I don't mind if they cheer as well. I like the Flatliners. They're exciting. Their tandem offense is unlike anything I've ever seen before. And although I have all the respect in the world for both Primo and Stickball, I'm rooting for the Flatliners in this one.
That's your opinion. Everyone's got them. Like I said, I'm solely behind the Italianos. Here we go. Nice headlock, Primo.
Primo, veteran, trying to keep his opponent grounded. Oh.
But again, you don't go into a strength contest. There you go. If you want to get into a strength contest, you get Stickball in there. There's the powerhouse.
Stickman, the big ball. The big Stickball.
Well, Stickball's the power. And Primo Scordino, he's the brains. He's the speed. He's the technician. Stickball's the powerhouse. He's the guy.
Sure, that Carboni slam is devastating.
If you have a problem.
Oh, look at this, he's like a tree, you just can't knock him down.
Exactly, Stickball's one of those guys, and when you get into a fight with him, you're getting an old school beatdown. That means you're going to get hit a lot more than you hit the other guy when you fight Stickball.
Well, I think the crowd wants to see Burns get in here. Asylum making the tag. We'll see how Burns fares. Oh, Stickball throws the line. Oh, and Burns with a big spinning heel kick takes down the big man of the Italianos.
I want to say one thing. Both men have great haircuts right now.
Big shoulder tackle there. Burns. Very funny, Chris. Burns.
Now there we go. Hard wrist lock. Nice tag. Here we go. We got some fast-paced tag team action. This is what the fans want to see.
Oh, sending Stickball into the corner. And now Asylum. Oh, full charge. And Burns, the neck breaker, and that's what I'm talking about.
There's that tandem offense, Topher.
That's just it.
Come on, Stickball.
Great sequence of moves, catching your opponent off guard.
There we go.
Big tackle. Gary Gambino controls Stickball.
It's not looking good for Primo right now. Oh!
Sidewalk slam, cover.
Oh. There we go.
And like we said, the winners of this contest will go on to face the team of Sexy Monkey and Go Time Chris LaPlante, your new Crossfire Tag Team Champions.
Now, the Flatliners are looking good right now. I didn't expect them to get the upper hand like this over the Italianos right now.
I did.
Oh, no. We've seen this before, Topher.
Absolutely. That delayed vertical suplex.
Now, I wonder, are they going to do the tag? Oh, yes, they are.
The tag. Here comes Burns.
Now, fans that don't know the Flatliners, this is what they do. They like to show off their power. This is impressive.
Keeping Primo's head downwards, making that blood rush that much longer.
This is impressive.
Plus seconds up in the air. Comes crashing down hard. Look at his head. Look how red he is.
Now that vertical suplex combination was something that even the British Bulldog would have been proud to see.
No doubt the Flatliners, a couple of Bulldogs in their own right.
Come on, right, Primo, show you with those cobwebs.
Yeah, Primo's having a hard time here collecting himself. Bodyguard taunting the Flatliners from the other side of the ring.
It's not smart to turn your back, though, on the Italianos. You do not want to do that.
Oh, he's buying his competitors some time here. A silence roar after the bodyguard.
That's not smart.
And the stick ball.
There we go. There we go. Turn the tides. When you run into a stick ball, you're running into a brick wall.
Absolutely. You ever run into a brick wall, Chris?
Nope.
No, you don't want
it. I haven't played Red Ass since I was a kid.
Pardon me.
That was an old game back in the preschool or the grade school days. You have a ball against the wall.
I prefer
you try to catch it.
I prefer the word raw ball myself. But nonetheless, Primo Scordino.
Oh, then you played a churched up version. If you dropped the ball and didn't get to the ball at first, we got to whip it at you.
I was banned in our playgrounds. Now Primo, having his opponent locked in the corner, also banned in wrestling. You're not allowed to corner your opponent. Referee doing his best to keep control here.
The referee does nothing. We've seen him in the past. We know he does nothing.
This is Eddington James's 996th wrestling match.
Too many, if you ask me.
He's old school. He's been around a long time.
So, doesn't make it good.
Chris, do you know how many matches that is?
Too many.
Have you even seen 996 matches?
Yes, I'm 32 years old and I have. Oh. I've seen over 1,000 matches in my lifetime.
Pardon me.
I've been watching wrestling since I was 3 years old.
Primo had the hair of Asylum.
Smart wrestling. There we go. Primo with a nice headlock chin lock there.
Well, you know, the Flatliners' offense doesn't involve them laying on the ground, so if he can keep Asylum on the ground, he can prevent them from getting in that tandem offense.
That's the brains of Primo Scordino right there. Like I said, he's got the brains, he's got the speed, stickball's the power, he's the force. It's a great combination of brains and bronze, speed and power. It's just two things that always go together. That's what the Italianos are.
The Italianos are a great team, and I don't disagree. But I really want to see the Flatliners do their awesome double team stuff and win this thing. Who would you rather see face off against Sexy Time? I mean, Monkey Business.
I'd rather see the Italianos.
All right, Asylum now getting to his feet. This crowd's firmly behind him. And look at the power!
Nice. That was a big
Samoan
drop.
Just what he needed. Can he get to Burns? Yes, he can.
Come on, Primo. Get out of there, buddy. Oh, no, it's not good,
He failed to make the tag now. Burns unloading on him.
Nice inverted atomic drop. To a drop kick combination.
Oh, Burns, you see some of that high-flying action there.
Burns getting the crowd behind him. There goes stickball. There we go.
Stickball trying to interfere with it. Not able to get the job done.
Oh, there we go.
Primo picked up the pieces.
There we go. Just like an Italiano to take the advantage anytime he can take it. He saw it open and he went there. There we go. Slow him down. Let's get the teamwork here.
Now Burns is isolated from his partner as the Italianos work together.
There we
go. Down. Oh, look at that stickball. Egging on Asylum. Now the referee distracted.
Come on, everything, James. Come on, old school.
Trying to do what he can to get Asylum out of there.
See, that's why he's not a good ref. He can't restrain anybody. You can't keep order. Be a ref.
Come on, look at a man like Asylum. Could any referee hold him back?
Yeah. Yeah, a referee that does his job.
Oh, come on now. Stickball blatantly bending that five count.
And there we go. There's your official again. Just let things slide. Oh, nice. Nice. Good kick to the ribs.
And again, the crowd doesn't want to see a match end with a rope break. You know what I mean? A disqualification for grabbing the ropes. Referee doing the best he can to give the crowd the shows that they want to see.
Stickball smart. Here we go. Speaking about tandem offense. There we go. Nice drop kick.
Yeah, great move there. That's some Italiano's tandem offense, and I do enjoy it.
Oh, come on. That was three.
If the Italianos can get this done fair and square, all the best to them. With that bodyguard out there, he's an equalizer, you know?
Hey, Gary hasn't done anything yet. He hasn't touched any of the flatliners. He hasn't done anything.
That asylum chasing him around the ring.
That's Asylum's fault for chasing him. He didn't have to do that. You keep your mind on the match. What's that? Eyes on the prize, the old saying goes.
All right, Chris, you got me for once. You didn't touch him.
Exactly.
All right, now Burns fighting up here.
Crowd's behind him.
Trying to keep him grounded now, and it's seeming to work. I'm on those knees in the midsection. Off the ropes. Oh, big Italian mafia kick.
That's what he's got to do.
Yeah, find him some recovery time.
Take him right to the head. That's what you got to do. That's the only way you're going to slow down the flatliners. Got to hit him right in the head. That's the only way they're going to feel it.
Yeah, we've got two veteran tag teams here in the Italianos and the flatliners. Both these guys are fighting the match like it's a tag team title match. As we see Burns there digging deep from the tank and a roll up.
Come on. There we go. But that's what it is. So Burns is starting to become tag champion. Nice clothesline.
Primo knew what needed to be done there. Stop the momentum of Burns dead in its tracks. And now here comes the big man. Here comes Stickball.
Tony Carboni's just going to lay it into him right now. Burns is in a nowhere state right now.
We're gonna see that big Carboni slam. Guy, this thing, you put him right through the ring. Burns slips out.
He's getting that second win right now.
Yeah, fighting up.
There we go.
Stickball. He's got him back up. Oh, what a Carboni slam. Drops him right in the center of the mat, and he's not moving.
Just slammed. Pin him.
He's not moving. That could be it.
Pin him.
Taking his time.
Pin him.
Asking the fans here at the Meredith Community Center if this is what they want. Look at this, so nonchalant, just resting his hands on him. And he has the nerve to argue with the official for it.
Well, this is a full cool can count properly and actually do an efficient speed on his count. That would have been three.
Well, Carboni would have followed up with the cover right away. He might have won this thing for the team.
Fans are getting behind Burns here. Asylum just reaching for that tag.
Yeah, I don't think Carboni realizes how close.
There we go. Nice.
He did realize how close Asylum was. Oh, what a big back body. And Asylum is not there. He's not able to
make
the tag.
Nice. Here we go. Come on, Primo.
The Italianos are. And now Primo.
Yes. There
Burns
we go.
Burns was there. He was there, Chris.
Oh, well, his partner wasn't. This is great. Come on, Primo. They ain't an old-fashioned beating. Come on.
I don't hear you cheering. He's got this match right back where he wants it. Opponent, center of the ring, on his back.
Now this is classic wrestling. That's what the Italianos do. They isolate your opponent, they work him down. Burns fighting back, but Primo won't allow it.
Oh, wait for that mafia kick once too many times. And now a big flapjack.
Great elevation there on the flapjack.
Just what Burns needed now. Look at Asylum, he's ready.
Oh, that was
look
a desperation
move. Did you see Asylum? He's so charged up, he could probably jump right over those ropes if he wanted to.
You gotta get tagged in to get in there though, Asylum.
Are both these guys gonna reach their partners?
He's gonna get there first. He's gonna get their toe first.
The Italianos did, and the Flatliners did too. Stickball and Asylum. Go. Look at the strength of Asylum throwing Stickball into the corner.
Part of the corner.
Oh, what a combination. Now Primo.
Whoa, what's he doing?
Into his own corner.
Primo just got tagged out. He should not be getting, he should be on the ring apron right now recuperating.
And now a meeting of the Italianos.
Not good.
Oh, big backdrop. Stickball in the air. Oh, wow. Oh, what a move. One, two. Oh, no. And Primo just elbowed his own partner. How embarrassing.
Not good. Not good. Come on. Asylum is just on fire. He's like a man possessed right now.
Asylum's ready for him.
Oh, what's this? What is this? Come on.
Sweeps the foot now. He's too battling now. What's the bodyguard doing up there? He has
still
no business
up there. See, again, Asylum grabbing a guy that doesn't, that didn't do nothing.
He's getting involved here. And now what's happening? Oh, come on, the bodyguard has
yes.
distracted.
Yes, he's got the kendo stick.
What's he
finally.
Trying to do here? Well, come on, ref, turn around.
Here we
come
go.
On,
come on, Primo, batters up.
This is your 996 batters match, crying out loud. Oh, jeez,
oh,
Louise.
Oh, wow.
Two.
Come on,
three.
Primo.
Yes, yes. The Flatliners win. The Flatliners.
Wow.
Chris, you know what this means. This means the Flatliners are the number one contenders for the tag team titles.
This is huge, Topher. We haven't seen the Flatliners in a while, and all of a sudden they're the number one contenders with a lucky victory. That kendo stick shot was epic. Wow.
To say that backfired would be an understatement.
Wow.
That blew up in their face.
Now that was something. That was something. And we have new number one contenders, the Flatliners. The crowd's behind them, Pope.
Sure they are. Who doesn't love the Flatliners?
I don't.
Yeah, I'm a huge Cody Deaton fan. I'm going for him, but I don't know how you can beat the Beast.
This is going to be a great Crossfire main event, folks. Here at Fired Up, Meriden Community Center in St. Catharines. What a show we're going to have here.
You can't get a better main event to close out the night. This is two Crossfire debuts, too, if I'm not mistaken, because Dieter and Severn, they've never been here before, so this is great.
We got that right. I believe this is Dan Severn's first wrestling match in St. Catharines. Dieter wrestling here before with other promotions in this area.
Well, I'm glad we got St. Catharines on the map for something.
Obviously, you don't know the rules of professional wrestling. You have to stand back. He's already cheating. Cheater. 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 Hold him back. He's already cheating.
I don't know if you want to poke the bear, Cody.
Stop calling me a chicken.
The fans are trying to while the feathers of Cody Deaner, so to speak.
Stop encouraging him! You can't do that! Listen! I have never tapped out in my life!
Deaner needs to shut his mouth and get in the ring.
I think he's just infuriating Dan Severn. That's not
if
good.
These people don't shut up! I'm gonna leave St. Catharines forever!
They don't seem to mind. We'll lose our main
shut
event.
Them up.
Oh, he's leaving. He's actually gonna go.
Don't forget to send me a postcard from wherever you come from, Deaner! Because before tonight is out, these people wanna see you!
He's not really going to walk away from this fight, is he?
A smart man would. I wouldn't want to get in there with Dan Severn.
Why don't the infamous one, Jay Moore, join me in the ring?
Oh.
Don't do it, Jay. Don't do it.
Jay Moore's got a bad rap with our special guest.
I challenge you, Jay Moore, to a little one-on-one wrestling competition.
Don't do it, Jay. That's a suicide mission.
Oh, come on, Jay. Get in there. Yeah.
That's suicide if you go in
wrestle
there.
Dan Severn. Get in the ring with him, just like you got in the ring with Rikishi and Jake Roberts.
You couldn't pay me enough money to get in the ring with him.
I'm inviting invited you into my home.
Come on, Jay, you're not gonna.
You know what? You're gonna be sorry that you ran your big, stupid mustache mouth. Jay Moore, you can do this. Yes, you can.
No.
Yes.
What?
Soften him up for me. Soften him up for me.
No, no, no.
Yes,
Cody can't.
Hey, can Jay Moore do this?
Cody can't be serious.
No, no, Cody.
I believe in you.
You got it?
No.
You're Beast Junior. I'm Beast Junior.
Okay, Jay Moore, he could be a lion.
These people will have to respect you.
Jay Moore's out of his mind. Out of his mind.
Come here.
He's brainwashed by Cody.
These people don't respect you. They're going to respect you after you make Dan Severn tap out. We can do this.
You got to be kidding me.
Come on, Jay.
Wait. We've got to start this a fair way. He said amateur rules, he's going to let him start with the advantage.
Really? I don't know if there's any advantage.
Jay Moore rules! Jay Moore rules!
Yes, Jay Moore rules.
I'll give it to him. It takes some guts to get in the ring with Dan Severn. I don't think Jay's thinking clearly right now. I think he's got a little too much Cody Deaner hype in him. A little too much adrenaline in the system. Does he even realize what he's doing, Chris?
This is not smart. Dan Severn is a beast, like his, just like he says. This is not
Jay
smart.
Jay Moore is about to grapple with Dan Severn.
This is something.
He's never had any formal training.
This is something. The fans are going to get their money's worth tonight.
You're talking about Rob Rage being a bodyguard. Jay Moore's a manager. Look at him.
Like I said, this is not smart. It's suicide going there with Dan Severn. Jay Moore's not a wrestler. He's a manager, just like you said.
We at least take that bandana off. He looks ridiculous. I can't believe this. He's not really gonna mount him.
Uh-oh.
No. It's give up, Jay. You're done. He's done. He's pinned. That's it. Well, congratulations, Jay. You just got beat by a UFC Hall of Famer.
Hey, that's nothing to look down upon.
At the end of the year, this should win for least surprising moment of the year. Jay Moore taps out to Dan Severn.
Yes, I guess everyone did see that one coming.
Even you saw it coming. Yes. Come on.
Jay Moore, we're not leaving here until these people respect you.
Oh, good luck.
Get in there and show them who the real Jay Moore is.
I don't believe this. He's not really going to convince him to get in there again, is he?
Well, pride makes a man do crazy things, and getting in the ring with Dan Severn is a crazy thing.
I've heard of blind pride before, but this is ridiculous. I think Dan Severn's asking for the advantage now. Come on, Jay. You guys schooled me, had the advantage. What do you think is going to happen?
This is not good. This is not good.
I don't believe it. Here we go. Dan Severn, look at the rolling leg lock. It's over. Two, it's a pin. Oh, and he's got the leg. Oh, he's got a leg.
Oh, wow.
He's shooting. He hooked his leg. I think he just ripped the groin. Oh, look at this. Stretching him now.
This is not good for Jay Moore.
Yeah, Jay's getting punctured. Look at this. Look at this. Schooling him.
Well, Dan Severn is a man that said he was going to educate Cody Deaner, but right now he's educating.
You want to talk about one-sided contests, Chris. Jay Moore's not going to educate. He's getting schooled. There's a difference. The only thing Jay Moore learned from that, hopefully, is to not get in the ring with Dan Severn ever again.
Like I said earlier, he couldn't pay me enough money to get in the ring with Dan Severn. He's not even wearing gloves. Imagine taking a punch by him.
Jay Moore's not moving. He's on the floor over there. I don't even know. I don't think we'll see him
He got stretched out so much he could have tore a pectoral muscle.
Well, that's what I mean. He got stretched.
Oh, no.
The Beast was toying with him. You're kidding.
Dan Severn hasn't even broke a sweat.
Now that J-Mar has had a little taste of what wrestling is all about, let's move on to volunteer number two. How about it, big man? You want to step in the ring?
Oh,
Come on in.
Rage,
Severn's calling out Rob Rage.
I think Rage just nodded. Did Rage just nod? Who has a smile on his face?
Well, what a debut. This will be for Rage. Get in the ring with the Beast.
Well, he did take on the man he's supposed to be bodyguarding, so.
At least Rob Rage stands a chance here against Dan Severn. I mean, I don't know how much. We haven't seen much from Rage, but he's built quite solidly. You got to think that if he gets his hands on the Beast, he might be able to throw him around a bit.
This is going to be interesting. This will be very interesting.
I'd say he stands a better chance, way better chance, than Jay Moore.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe even in a one-on-one wrestling contest, a better chance than Cody Deaner.
Look how big Rage is. He's jacked. He's ready to go.
That's right. I got these.
Come on, easy, don't poke the bear.
We all know conditioning goes beyond physical appearance.
Just look at those tough man contests. Some of those guys look like they have a gut, but they can still pull a Mack truck.
Well, that's just it.
Are they going to do a test of strength here?
I think so. I think if any contest would favor Rage, it'd be a test of strength. Not only does he have, bigger muscles, but he's also got the height advantage.
And this is something you don't see every day in wrestling is a test of strength. You don't see that anymore.
No, this is old school, but, I mean, the Beast is an old school competitor. Rage, very much so a strongman, bodybuilder. But he's going toe-to-toe with the Beast. The Beast
is... Oh, there we go. Who's going to get some leverage here?
The Beast has him right now.
Oh,
the Beast has... Or, sorry, Rob Rage has him right now.
He's taking him down to one knee.
The big man, Rage, has Severn on one knee.
I never thought I'd see this.
But he's relentless. The Beast is not giving up easily. He's back up to a vertical base.
Come on, Rage. Don't let him turn those arms.
Now look at him back and Rage. Oh, no. It's Deaner.
Yes. That's how you do it, Cody. That's how you do it. The thinking man's wrestler, Cody Deaner.
He blindsided Dan Severn with that attack.
Take the advantage any way you can.
Yeah, Severn was about to win the test of strength with Rob Rage. But now he's got Deaner. Now it's on to the third member of the Infamous Five.
Here we go. Now the match is finally underway. Here we go. Let's go, Deaner.
Here we go. Your main event here for Fired Up.
I know I'm fired up for this.
Cody Deaner, the newest member of the Infamous Five group, led by Jay Moore, versus Dan the Beast Severn.
I see that Jay Moore is finally up to his feet after that, after being stretched out by Dan Severn earlier.
Oh, yeah, this match started with Severn challenging Jay Moore and schooling him in an amateur wrestling contest.
Nice,
and then taking down Rob Rage in a test of strength. And now, our scheduled main event, Severn and Deaner. Severn just schooled Deaner. Deaner's back out on the floor.
Yeah, it's not lost a step. This is great seeing Dan Severn back in the ring. That was a beautiful arm drag. He has not lost a step.
Yeah, I mean, say what you will. Dan Severn, yeah, his prime might have been in the 90s, but the man is still a beast. There's no doubting that.
I honestly would not fight him even this day. I wouldn't even fight him 10 years from now. That's how intimidating Dan Severn is. Oh, hard hit, Cody Deaner.
I wouldn't fight Dan Severn 10 years from now. That's how intimidated I am of this man. Look at
the beast. Look at that. Nice. Swinging the arm there. You don't see this too often in wrestling. I'm liking this.
This is old school. This is Dan Severn style.
Hard chops.
Dan Severn dropped toe hold.
Oh.
Oh, and it rolls through to an ankle lock.
Yeah, it's like a variation almost. Come on, Deaner, get to the ropes.
Yeah, Deaner's got the ropes. There's Jay Moore, you're right, he's back to his feet. He's still hobbling, though. He got stretched by Dan Severn in the opening moments.
Seeing that makes, like I said earlier, you cannot pay me enough to get in the ring with Dan Severn. Winner's purse, loser's purse, doesn't matter. You couldn't pay me enough to get in there. Like, if I was Cody Deaner, I'd use my speed to the advantage right now against Dan Severn.
Deaner's off his game right now. He's frustrated. When the Deaner tactics don't work, he's got to turn to something else.
Like, Dan Severn has all the experience, like, all the knowledge. So if I was Cody Deaner, I'd try to use my speed. That's the only thing I could see Cody Deaner have the advantage in his speed right now.
If he's not careful, he'll find himself real quick in a leg grapevine.
Well, that's what makes these UFC fighters so tough to fight, because no matter what you do, they know a reversal to put you in a submission hold. Like, look at that. Nice fireman. Like,
there it is. There's that arm.
There's the arm bar. Fireman's carrying to an arm bar. That's smart by Deaner. He's locking the fingers, trying not let Severn get that hold in.
Well, not only has Dan Severn come from the UFC, a great hub for all mixed martial arts, but he comes out with a wrestling background.
Yes, like I mentioned, Al, he was an All-American, an alternate for the Olympic the Olympic wrestling team.
And that was before UFC. That was before everything else. This guy's career has spanned decades. And he hasn't lost a step.
No, he has not. I was just about to say that. Great minds think alike, Topher.
I think it's obvious, coming from my point of view.
Like, I remember being a kid watching Dan Severn in those UFC tournaments, just watching in awe.
You were allowed to watch UFC as a kid?
I sure was.
Old school 90s UFC?
Gotta love having older brothers.
You got some lenient parents, I'll tell you what.
Older brothers, they'd rent the show. It was great, but I remember just watching him in awe. And I'm almost at the same stature I was as a kid, just in awe of Dan Severn. He'll mess you up if you're not careful.
Well, I was never allowed to watch the UFC events, but I did watch old school WWF. Back in the Attitude Era, I remember when Ken Shamrock came, the world's most dangerous man, and soon after, Dan Severn also came from the world of the UFC into the WWF, and I remember the impact he left. Who could forget his classic Lion's Den match against Owen Hart in the Hart Dungeon? He put Owen's head through the roof.
He sure did. That was one of the best feuds, and does not get mentioned enough, Dan Severn and Owen Hart.
Well, the Beast has now arrived in St. Catharines, 2014, against Cody Deaner. Here at Crossfire Wrestling's fired up.
Well, Dan Severn's so legit, his MMA record speaks for itself. 101 wins, 19 losses, 7 draws.
101 wins.
And he's still fighting to this day.
Do you know how many wins that is, Chris?
It's a lot of wins.
It sure is.
And here's a fun fact that not too many people know about. Dan Severn also trained current TNA Tag Team Champion Eddie Edwards for his match against his tag partner Davey Richards in Ring of Honor.
Is that true? And Eddie Edwards, a great up-and-comer on the indie scene, actually now with TNA Wrestling.
Current tag champion with Davey Richards. And Dan Severn helped train him, which is pretty good.
Severn leaving a legacy in his own right and also training the up-and-coming generation.
This is smart. That's the only way you're going to get Dan Severn's number
right now. He's being ganged up on by Rage and Jay Moore. Jay Moore thinks he's tough. Did you forget what happened 10 or so minutes ago?
Oh. You know what they say. Once the pain's gone, that's the best. That then you forget everything. Once you don't feel it anymore, you just forget it.
I guess pain is temporary. Pride is forever. But I think Jay Moore's pride got hurt, and he just doesn't realize it yet.
I don't know. Being in there with Dan Severn, if he didn't get schooled, I would have been shocked.
I suppose, yeah, that would have won the award for most surprising. Jay Moore taps out Dan Severn.
Or Jay Moore lasts longer than 5 minutes.
Jay Moore lasts longer than 5 seconds?
Yeah.
Perhaps.
Here we go. Deaner's taking control. Yeah, this is good. It's the only way you're going to beat Dan Severn. You can't give him an inch.
Yeah, Deaner's lasted more than a few minutes in this contest, but he owes a huge help to Rage, who right now is choking Dan Severn in the corner. The referee, Eddington James.
You can blame him for that. James should not be talking to Cody Deaner. He should be more concerned about what's going on.
Well, Deaner knows exactly what's going on. He was creating that diversion intentionally.
That's why Deaner's a thinking man's wrestler.
And now he's got Severn centered in the ring. Shinlock applied. This could be over right here. Imagine that. Cody Deaner taps out UFC Hall of Famer Dan Severn.
That's something.
Or knocks him out.
That's something we can add to his resume. Tapped out a UFC legend.
And it would actually be legitimate. Kevin Nash, SummerSlam. Jeez Louise.
This is smart. Jay Morris helping Cody Deaner there. There we go. Put the legs on the ropes.
The infamous family, early quiet. You can tell that's why they were going for the feet on the ropes, but Eddington James actually saw it this time.
Surprised he saw anything.
Oh, right hand, Severn blocks it. Shot to the midsection.
You don't get into a punching contest with Dan Severn. UFC taught us that. You do not get into a punching contest with
him. They taught you that.
Facts. Hardcore facts. When I seen some of the guys' faces after Dan Severn was done with them, that showed me right there I never want to get hit by them. There we go.
Oh, look at this. And now again, Rage and Moore are just taking it to the beast.
See, if James was doing his job, he'd be on top of this, but he's not. That's why he's an NF official.
Right. That's right.
Crossfire needs to get on top of this.
I'm glad you see things from my perspective, Chris.
Well, it happens both ways. It happens both ways. I've seen him screw up earlier tonight. I've already mentioned it. I call my shenanigans during that Jeremy Elliott, Chris LaPlante tag match.
What a match that'll be, December 6th. Jeremy Elliott putting his career on the line in his title match with Tomer Shalom, with Jay Moore's career on the line as well.
I don't think it's fair. He's going after the belt. He shouldn't get Jay Moore's career added to it. Nice shot, Cody Deaner. Soften him up a bit. Here we go.
Going to work on Severn there in the corner. The Beast may have more than a handful here in Cody Deaner, because he's also got Rage and Moore. And look at this, a scoop slam to the Beast.
I've not seen Cody Deaner do that move before. The body slam is making its way back into wrestling, ladies and gentlemen. This is what I like to see. It's not this Mickey Mouse BS you see other places. This is a straight-up wrestling match.
Well, maybe Cody Deaner's trying to show his traditional wrestling side to Dan Severn, you know? Impress him with what he knows, a scoop slam.
As he should. Deaner's no slouch. He's been champions in everywhere he's been.
Deaner really taking his time with that second rope, gloating in front of the fans.
I think you're taking too much time, Cody.
Oh, he sure is. Nobody home for that elbow drop. Severn rolled out of the way, and now he's up on his feet.
Dan Severn's a beast.
That's what it says in his tights.
It's not just that's a nickname that does him justice. It's what other word could describe Dan Severn. Vicious.
You're right. I wasn't implying that he wasn't a beast.
Yes.
I'm just saying it's no secret that he is a beast.
Exactly.
Look at these flurry of uppercuts, sending Deaner for a ride.
Huge
left-handed lariat. What a move.
Deaner's on Dream Street, it looks like.
Oh, now a big splash in the corner. Severn looking great here.
It looks like he's having fun. That's not good. When Dan Severn's having fun, that means you're getting hurt.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Oh, what a takedown and into an armbar.
No.
Into an armbar. This could be it.
Get to the ropes, buddy. Get to the ropes. Rage, grab his foot. Grab his foot.
He's too far away. He'll never make it.
Come on. Come on, Deaner. Get there. Yes.
Deaner's going to tap. Oh, wait a minute. Rage. Rage is dragging him. Rage dragged him a few feet.
Come on, ref.
Cody Deaner would have tapped out in that hole, and you know it.
He was on the ropes. Old school should have been doing his five count. Right there, shenanigans.
Well, Deaner survived for a little bit longer. But Severn's not going to shake your hand now. It's too late for handshakes.
Show some sportsmanship. Come on, man.
Do you really think Deaner's being genuine with this handshake?
He's on his knees. He's like, come on, man. Shake my hand.
Yeah, he's vulnerable, and he's going for desperation here. Severn knows better than shake his hands. Oh, he's doing it. He's doing it. Oh, there it is. Oh, wait a minute.
No. Severn seen that coming.
Oh, sure he did. Big back suplex from the Beast.
Look at that impact.
Deaner's reeling from that one. And now there's an ankle lock.
Oh, no.
There's the ankle lock.
No.
There's the ankle lock. We've seen Deaner tap to this before.
No.
But now he's got Eddington James. What's he doing? Using them for leverage to get up to his feet.
Oh, no.
Uh-oh. German suplex. Oh, but Deaner's still hanging on to the ref.
This is smart, Deaner. Come on. You don't want to. Oh, nice elbow.
Big elbow. Wow.
You don't want to take a German suplex. Oh, no.
Oh, and now Deaner's going to suplex him. Oh, whips him by the hair right into the referee.
Yes.
Oh, give me a break.
Get some good officiating now.
He intentionally whipped Dan Severn into the referee.
He should have been standing there.
Stand there. He tried to move.
Oh, Deaner's got the chain.
Yes. Oh, no. Not like this. Well, we've got a legendary wrestler here. And you're going to hit him with a piece of metal?
Damn right. One way to take down a beast is with a chain. You chain the beast.
Oh, wait. No. Severn saw it.
Oh, no.
Sweeps the leg. Look at this. It's over now.
Oh, no.
It's over now.
Come on. Look at the pressure he's put on the ankle. Jay Moore in the ring. Yes.
Oh, Jay Moore breaking up the hold.
Thank you, Jay. Thank you.
Referee's out. Doesn't see it. Oh, now Jay Moore's going to offer the handshake. You think he...
Oh, no. Jay, don't get out of there. Get out of there, Jay.
Oh, wait. There's rage now.
That's what he's paid for. He's going to be the bodyguard.
Now we got three guys in the ring against Dan Severn. Oh, Diener's up. Turn around, Dan. Turn around. Look out. Oh. Severn's down. Diener just leveled the beast with that chain.
Wake up, old man. Get up. Come on.
Oh, now Eddington James is up.
Come on.
Severn's down. Making the count. He didn't see the chain. Severn still gets the shoulder up.
How slow was that count?
Of course it was slow. The ref got knocked out. But Severn.
This ref is a joke. He is terrible. I couldn't see a slower count ever.
After being pummeled in the head with that chain, Severn still gets the shoulder up. Amazing.
Tap him out, Diener.
Oh, now Diener's got the ankle lock.
This is insult to injury if you can beat a man with his own move.
Uh-oh, wait a minute. Severn rolls through.
Oh, no.
He gets the ankle. Oh, is Diener going to get the rope? Diener, fingertips away. Fingertips away.
Come on, get to the rope, get to the rope.
He's got more.
Oh.
Oh, wait, no, he doesn't. He slipped.
He pulled him back. Dan Severn pulled him back. He's like almost in the middle of the ring.
Diener's in the center of the ring.
Come on,
nowhere
Diener.
To go. Eddington right there. It's over. Cody Diener taps. Diener taps. Severn wins. What a match.
What a match.
Wow. Dan Severn has done it, folks. In a 3-on-1 with Thor and Rage at ringside. Dan Severn made Cody Diener tap. He is your winner. The Beast reigns supreme.
This was rigged. That referee is terrible. And now Cody Diener's going down as a tap-out loss. That is terrible. Diener never taps out.
What a win that was. What a way to end. Fired Up 3, Crossfire Wrestling, Dan, the Beast Severn, standing tall over the Infamous 5.
I knew it was going to be a tough night for Cody Diener, but Dan Severn is just a beast.
Is this going to be the last fight where we're going to see the Infamous 5 with Jay Moore? Is he going to lose his career on December 6th with the Crossfire heavyweight title on the line?
He better not. Oh, looks like Dan Severn's got something to say. I better shut up here. I don't want to get knocked out.
It's a good idea.
You can't go. You can't go.
Come on. Now they're just rubbing it in.
You can't go. You can't go.
No, he didn't. That was a slow count. Diener had Dan Severn pinned. That was a slow count. That was a slow count. I gotta get my lawyer on the phone.
And thank Kevin, enjoy what just happened to you. Diener and the Madness One, and you also, Rob Rage, be gone with you.
Whoa.
I just want to take a moment here to thank all you fans for coming out here and supporting Crossfire Professional Wrestling. If it wasn't for your loyalty, this promotion couldn't stand and be able to bring people in such as myself. So from the bottom of my heart, thank you very much for coming out.
Jeremy Elliott is lucky to even be in this match. There's no reason why a guy that just shows up here, as he said, never been in the big one. So how the heck do you become number one contender like that? This is ridiculous. He doesn't deserve the shot. He doesn't.
He proved himself in a tag team match.
In a tag team match, exactly. What is a tag team match have to do with single competition? So you can love stupid
beliefs.
The match is set. It's about to start. The Crossfire heavyweight title is on the line.
No, no, no. It's just- just Crossfire Wrestling just trying to break up the infamous fight because they know they can't handle the infamous fight. We're the reason that everybody is here today. It is Jay Moore and the infamous fight. It's not. No one came here to see Jeremy Elliott. No one came here to see the flat
circle. Jay Moore's absence. And now Reigns got in here. The match didn't start. The bell didn't ring. But now Elliott with a Lucez press.
No, no, no.
And he's not waiting for no bell.
You don't kick Rage. Get him, Rage. Come on. Here we go. Yeah! There we go! That is Rob Rage, ladies and gentlemen.
Rage is just pounced the number one contender. And now referee, what? Eddington James kicking him out.
Now that is BS, Eddington James. He kicked Rob Rage. He kicked him.
Great call, referee. Just the thing to do for your 997th match.
That was BS. That is BS. That is total BS. Jeremy Elliott kicked Rob Rage. Rob Rage deserves to hit him back.
Rob Rage shouldn't have been in there to begin with.
The match didn't even start yet. We don't even know bell. The match hasn't started. If the match started, then he'd be up to the ring.
Oh, wait a minute.
There we go. It's ridiculous.
You can't get me out.
Hey, shut some light on this.
We have a mono main event here.
Wait a minute. Now he's getting to it. Let's regard this. Come on, James. There we go. Now we got it done. One,
not like
two.
This. Not, oh. Thank goodness. Jeremy Elliott hanging on. His career's on the line, folks.
As it should be. That's what you should have to put on the line for getting a world title shot in a tag match. It's ridiculous.
You can't keep arguing it because the outcome is you got this title.
Oh, yeah, then we got crooked officiating. We got backstage politics that just completely is screwing me in this spot. We should be wearing lipstick right now for how badly we're getting screwed. Just so we know we look good.
Come on, Tomer.
If anyone's seen the movie before, you know exactly what I'm talking about.
He's a little hard.
It's pure lipstick. There we go, Tomer. Take it to him. That is our world champion, ladies and gentlemen.
Jeremy Elliott here is in a bad way as the champion of Crossfire Wrestling, Tomer Shavone, now with his manager, the infamous Jay Moore. You know, it's interesting. Jeremy Elliott's been squaring the line against the Jay Moores. And like you said, Tomer's sort of been lost in the shuffle in all this. He's obviously the champion. He's obviously the one who's here at Crossfire.
And you can tell the video guys forgot about him in those promo videos. There we go, Randy Elliott and Jay Moore have both put on their careers on the line.
We'll never see one of them again after tonight.
After tonight, Christmas is going to come early, Crossfire, because we're no longer going to see that ugly face of Jeremy Elliott anymore. There's no way the longest reigning world champion is going to lose to a snow like this. This
match is on the other side for quite some time. Both men risking a count out. What a shame to throw away the main event like this.
Tomer, keep taking it to him, buddy. Yes, again in the apron.
Side of the ring there, very hard part of the ring.
In case the fans didn't know, that's steel
there. Sure it is.
If you didn't know, look it up. How do they do that? Look up how you put a wrestling ring together. You know that is steel. It does the damage to the lower back.
And this match coming around the ring towards us here. Jeremy Elliott, Elliott control, ramming Tomer off the side of the ring.
Come on, Tomer.
All right, what's Elliott going for here? Oh, a nice head shot right in front of the fans. They're loving it.
Shades of Ricky Steamboat with that shot. Old school, get your mind on the match. Quit looking at that, Jay. This referee needs to do his job, for Christ's sake.
Now, these two need to get in the ring.
If this ref did his job, I mean, it could get in here.
Right now going out there, throwing a back chop.
Come on, turn it around.
Adding insult to injury.
Come on, Tomer. There we go. Nice boot. Yes. Now this is what I expect from a world champion. There we go.
What he's going to do is Elliott. Right to the pole. Oh, my goodness.
Tomer Shavone has just been put insult to injury on that back.
insult to injury. He's been working that floor back to turn match to break it up and count down smart. We know the ref is going to do the count. There we go.
And neither is this.
Here we
why
go.
Why is he on the table?
Why should we?
I guess Tomer's in a position where
his belt's under the hook. Tomer Shield is here defending Jay Moore's career. Jay Moore is the reason that Tomer Shield is a crossfire wrestler.
But if Tomer gets disqualified, doesn't that mean that Jay Moore wins? And therefore,
doesn't
Jay Moore's
title.
No, but doesn't mean Jay Moore's out of the company?
No, no, I say career looks just like the title. You can't lose your career unless it's pitfall or submission. Here we go, it's kind of like Fireman Scary.
These fans are on their feet here at the Marion Community Center.
Standing room only, that's how packed we are. And so let's go to that table. But Elliot, he's standing tall.
I think he may have put Thomas Long through that table.
Come on, Thomas. Longest reigning world champ for a reason. Come on, Thomas.
And a very dangerous part of the ring there on the apron of the ring. It's a long way down if they fall.
There we go. Oh, here we go. I think we're going to get Jeremy Elliott to a table right here. Come on. That table is set off.
Is that table? That table is still standing.
Yes, it is.
Oh, no. This is really bad. Jeremy, you got to get out of this.
Come on, come on. Put him through. End him.
Oh, Jeremy slips out of it. Oh, a big kick. And Thomas teetering. Thomas teetering on the edge of the ring. And Jeremy's warming up that boot. Warming up that big punch. Yes. Oh, no. Nobody home.
There we go.
Jeremy,
that's our world champ.
Oh. That is our world champ. Things almost got crazy here. Jingle Bell Brawl for me.
And what better way to close out 2014?
No doubt, this match is... After all the hype here.
This is what the fans want to see. This is what I want to see. This is what you want to see. This is the match everyone's been talking about. And here we got the Forgotten Man, the match. Cover slow. Oh, no.
Catches
no. Not caught. It's in the armbar. No.
Thomas tapped out to this before.
Get to the ropes, Thomas. Get to the ropes. Come on.
Come on, Jeremy. Your career's on the line.
Oh, is that the rabbi?
The rabbi's coming out here. Oh no.
And look at this. Jeremy Owens is attacking a guy from walking down a ramp.
We all knew what the rabbi was out here to do. Jeremy Owens not taking no nonsense.
Right. He's a spiritual advisor. He don't just attack the guy. He's a rabbi.
Yeah, hard one.
Oh, there we go.
Taking this moment.
That's why you never won the big one. You're not paying attention on the champion.
And that could be really bad for Jeremy Elliott. We all know how much he uses those kicks and those feet. And if he just got his ankle jarred, that's going to mean he won't even be able to stand, never mind through the boot.
Exactly. Nice uppercut, Comer. Keep it going. Good boots. Thomas Shalom is just cutting off the auction. This game, yeah, it is great.
Bending the rules here.
This referee doesn't even know the rules.
Look at Jay. Look at Jay taunting Jeremy on the side of the ring.
Well, as he should, because there's no reason why Jay Moore's career should be on the line, but Jeremy Ellis getting a title shot for nothing.
Out of the line here, it's not just the belt, it's both their careers. Tomer obviously doesn't want to be responsible for Jay Moore leaving the business.
Oh, and he won't be responsible because there's no way Tomer Shalom is losing. Jay Moore brought Tomer Shalom to the crossfire. There's no way he's going to let Jay Moore down tonight. If this referee could actually count, we would have the match over by now.
Jay Moore spitting in the official's face.
As he should. I would if I was in Jay Moore's position. This referee is a travesty. He's a shambler. He's a joke.
Yeah, Jeremy's got Tomer in the corner. Lining up for those punches. Come on, ref. We got all 10 of them in. Sending Tomer in the opposite corner.
back, Mardi Gras.
Come on, Tomer.
Come on, Jeremy, you got this.
Tomer, get up, buddy.
This is your moment, Jeremy.
He can't do it. He doesn't have it in him. He's never won the big one. I don't care about his martial arts background. Here we go. Here we go. Stand by with Jerry.
Oh, there it is. That's a bicycle kick. No. There it is, Jeremy. No. Make the cover. Make the cover, Jeremy.
Get up, Tomer.
The thousand is yours.
Get up.
Tomer took Jeremy a little bit too long to make the cover. Oh, wait a minute. Another member of the Infamous Five. There's Morgan Stryan.
Here we go. Thank you. Thank you. Now we got things under control here. Morgan Stryan is here to help out. Help out his fellow Infamous Five member here.
Let's do it.
Oh, it's a nice hoodie.
Don't DQ him, ref. Don't do the DQ.
Take him down, custom.
There we go.
What the?
Eddington James showing him how it's done. He's only three matches away from 1,000 matches. And he gets knocked out.
Come on.
Finally getting his hands on my side.
Get this jobber out of here. Get this jobber out of here.
That's the best in my life.
Get this jobber out of here.
Whoa! Marcus Ryan sent for a ride, and Mark House is on the chase.
Come on, Custom, get out of here!
Mano a mano, one-on-one, the way this match is supposed to be.
No, that's what it means.
Now Tomer's
short. Oh, the belly. Wow, come on, Tomer, come on!
Could that be enough?
Oh, oh, thank you! Oh, come on, that was a little too close to talk to Tomer.
Oh, look at Jeremy. He just kissed Jaymore goodbye.
Well, he threw a kiss.
No.
He's saying sayonara.
No.
Adios.
He's delusional.
Bye-bye. See ya.
Yes.
Oh,
good jawbreaker. Way to go, Tomer.
Come on, Tomer.
Sit down, Classic Chris.
Oh, way, Tomer. 2 minutes.
Come on, Tomer.
Here staying on their feet. This match is so intense.
As they should be. This is the way you end up crossfire for 2014. You have a match like this. Career versus career. World title on the line.
My goodness, King of Death.
Wow. This is our champion.
He's signaling for the gold, waiting for Tomer. He's got the left foot ready.
Come on. Come on,
this crowd's going crazy here at the American Community Center. Everyone wants to see the big boot.
No. Come on, Tolbert. Why you're the world champ, buddy. Come on.
Oh, it's just Jeremy Elliott move. Jeremy Elliott gets out of the way. And now Jeremy's stealing Tolbert's move.
Come on, Tolbert. Come on, Tolbert. There we go. There we go.
Sweep the whole blood. He's going to choke the life out of a contender.
So come on, Tolbert. Come on, buddy. Oh, Elliott.
Where's all the bash into the corner, break the drip, and Tolbert's gonna latch back on. He's riding Jeremy.
That is smart. When you get on top of it, you're putting all your weight on him. That's what you put off the air.
He's catching his breath now. Oh, and again.
There we go.
And everybody goes through. Great judo takedown there, Jeremy Elliott. Oh, nice tuning it up,
Tolbert.
Nice tuning it up, gonna hit the bicycle kick. Oh, Tolbert moves out of the way again.
Yes.
Yes. There's the boot! There's the boot!
Get up! Roll out!
And Jeremy's down, and Tolbert's down, and both down!
Down the boat!
Jeremy, you gotta make the cover! Roll over! Get over there! The belt is yours! 1, 2!
What's going on? What's going on outside? Jeremy Elliott looks like he's getting into a team more! Oh no, Jay Moore!
Oh no, Jay Moore, get what's coming to him! Jeremy Elliott knows this will be the last time he can get his hands on Jay Moore if he retires him, or if he retires himself.
Get Rage out here! Get Rage out here!
All right, Tolbert now, capitalizing on distraction.
Guys!
Jeremy had him.
Jeremy has knocked
him. I got it, boy!
Here we go. What's this? Is Jeremy Elliott's son grabbing the chair? Elliott's son's got the chair! Elliott's son's got the chair!
Nick now fighting with Jay Moore over the chair!
Oh my god! Elliott hits Moore in the chair! Jeremy Elliott just hit Jay Moore in the chair! This is ridiculous!
That's right, Jeremy! Show him! Show him!
No! This is ridiculous!
Show him what he deserves! Oh! He's gonna get some attacks over! Attacking a teenager! Tolbert just spared Jeremy Elliott
the table! He just went through the table! Oh, wow! Did you hear the thud out of that, Tolbert?
Yeah, I didn't see the landing of both men crash.
That was a thud if I ever heard it. Now that was flesh through table to concrete.
Yeah, judging by the reactions of the small children in the front row, that was quite a horrific fall both men just took there. I hope they're both okay. I hope this match can continue.
I just warn people, you better not bring your kids to a pro wrestling show because this is what you might see.
No children are being harmed right now.
It's a little too graphic for you to watch. I can tell how they're all worried there in the front row.
It may be something they'll never forget, but that's just it. It's a lifetime memory here at Crossfire Wrestling, Jingle Bell Brawl 3.
First ever career match too, by the way, in the history of Crossfire Wrestling.
Yeah, this will be the last time you ever see either Jeremy Elliott or the manager of the champion, Jay Moore.
We are not going to see the end of Jay Moore. That is ridiculous. The fans are here to see Jay Moore. No one cares about Jeremy Elliott. Nobody does.
Well, we might even see the end of Jeremy Elliott after Tolbert speared him off the apron through that table that was still set up at ringside. That table set up long ago during this contest. I almost forgot about it.
That was beautiful. Tolbert Shalom, he just showed the reason why he is the world champion. Things like that. The table was set. Jeremy Elliott was in place. He pounced on it.
I really don't want to see this match and this night and this year end with a double countout. What would happen? Whose career would end? Both of them?
No, Jeremy Elliott's, because Tolbert Shalom will keep the world title. The winner is the champion. Whoever keeps the title, he keeps the career.
Referee's at an 8. He's going to get a couple more seconds. I can't
see
them.
Come on, Tolbert, get in.
I see a hand. Jeremy Elliott's up.
Tolbert's first one in. Tolbert's in.
Tolbert's
in.
Come on,
9, ref, 9.
No, they broke the count. They both got in the ring.
I think Tolbert broke the count because he wants to pin him like a man. Come on, Tolbert!
Both men having trouble getting their feet. That must have been a hard fall there on the concrete floor here at the Meredith Community Center.
It's something the fans will never forget, Topher.
Oh, big arm! Now that goes off the walls.
Now that was a strike.
Oh, but Elliott fires back with a huge forearm of his own, and now Tober's reeling.
Come on, Tober! Get him back, buddy!
Oh, yes. My goodness.
Did you hear the impact on that one?
It's just flesh on flesh.
Tober had so much impact on that, he was on the 1D after that shot.
Look at Jeremy. Jeremy's madder than ever. Delivering a forearm of his own.
Tober's in the ropes, pulling himself back up.
Yeah, both guys can barely stand right now. Oh my goodness.
There we go. Come on, Tober.
And now a discus forearm. Can you believe it?
Oh no.
And now he's going for the arm again.
Come on, Tober.
The arm.
Get to the rope. Get to the rope. Get to the rope. Grab the ref. I don't care.
If he gets him down, we're going to have a new Crossfire champion here. Okay. He's got the arm bar locked in.
He's fighting it. Tober's got his fingers hooked. There we go. Reverse. 1, 2, 3. Come on, ref. His shoulders were down.
Oh, Tober plants him.
What's with the ref?
Modified power, but ref was counting it. Tober lifted Jeremy.
No. He was down for a three.
Here's the count now. 1. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Jeremy's got the arm bar.
No. He doesn't have a fully hook. Come on, Tober.
He's trying.
Lock the wrist.
He's trying.
Lock it.
Now he's got it.
No, we don't.
Yes, we do.
This is BS. We had a pitfall.
He is the new Crossfire Wrestling Heavyweight Champion.
This is ridiculous.
Jeremy Elliott has won the big one.
No. I have to get my lawyer on this.
And we all
this
know.
This is ridiculous.
Yeah, we
I
all
blame
know.
Old school. This guy cannot officiate nothing. He is the worst official I've ever seen in wrestling.
There was a stipulation, if you'll recall, that the losing team had to retire. Jay Moore on the losing team. His Crossfire career is over. I can't believe it, Chris.
No. This is ridiculous.
Wow. What a moment for Jeremy Elliott. Not only is he the new Crossfire champion, but his arch rival, Jay Moore, is no longer here at Crossfire Wrestling. What a way to end 2014 year. Christmas has come early for me.
No. This is Scrooge. We got Scrooge. Infamous Five got screwed over by Crossfire Wrestling. This is BS. A guy that doesn't even deserve to get a title shot gets one. Luckily gets a win. And now Jay Moore's done. No. This will not stand.
He overcame the impossible odds.
This will not stand. This is bull. Complete BS.
Chris, will you watch your mouth? This is a family show.
This is bull.
I know, you love Jay Moore. But now you gotta say goodbye.
Slap him, please. Slap that guy for being a mook.
I don't think Jay Moore can believe it. He looks like he's in shock. He's taking this way too well.
This is ridiculous.
Look at him. He's not saying a word.
This is ridiculous.
Have you ever seen Jay Moore speechless?
He shouldn't be. He got screwed out of his managerial job. This is ridiculous.
Your new heavyweight champion.
This is ridiculous. Oh my God, this is ridiculous.
Jeremy Elliott has done it.
Congratulations, you finally won one.